In this video, we are going to learn about area. Area is something we can discover about shapes. The area of a shape refers to how much space is inside of it. Area is very different from perimeter. If you'll remember, perimeter is the space around a shape. Area is the space inside of a shape. Alright, so area is the space inside of a shape, and perimeter is the space around a shape. So they're very different, aren't they? And this video is all about area. We're going to learn how to find the space inside of a shape. This should be fun. Let's play a game called What's the Area? We want to find the area of this shape. What kind of shape is this? Yeah, a square. Remember, the area of a shape is the space inside of the shape. We are going to measure the area of the shape using square units. So, the area of the shape is how much space is inside of it. So, how many square units are inside of this square? Do you know? If you don't, just count them up. Yeah, 4. There are 4 square units in this square. 4 square units is the area of this square. Okay, that was cool, right? Let's try figuring out the area of this rectangle. Just like last time, we are going to measure the area of this rectangle using square units. Remember, the area of a shape is the space inside of the shape. So, how many square units are in this rectangle? Do you know? Yeah, there are 5 square units in this rectangle. Great job! That's the area of this rectangle. 5 square units. Awesome. Now we are going to look at an irregular shape. What is the area of this shape? Just like we did with the others, we are going to measure the area of this shape using square units. How many square units are inside of this shape? Feel free to pause this video to give yourself time to count them. Were you able to count all of them? How many square units are in this shape? What is the area of this shape? Yeah, 12 square units. Great job. There are 12 square units in this irregular shape. So far, finding the area has been very easy because we've shown you the inside of the shape, so all you have to do is count how many units are inside. But what if you can't see the units inside the shape? What if there are just numbers that you know and you have to come up with the area another way? Here is the fun part. To find the area of a shape, you have to use multiplication. Yeah, multiplication! So, how do you find the area of a square or a rectangle using multiplication? All you have to do is multiply the length times the width to get the area. Here, we'll show you. Let's say we want to find the area of this rectangle. It is 6 feet long and 1 foot wide. Remember, to find the area of a square or a rectangle, all we have to do is multiply the length times the width. The length times the width is the area. It's just simple multiplication. So we would write 6 times 1. 6 times 1 will give us the area of this rectangle. What is 6 times 1? Do you know? Yeah. 6 times 1 is 6. Whenever you multiply a number times 1, it stays the same. So our answer is 6 feet squared. That little 2 next to feet means squared. It tells us that the rectangle has 6 square feet of space inside. The area is 6 feet squared. Why don't we try another one? Let's say we want to find the area of this square. It is 3 centimeters long on each side. Remember, to find the area of a square or a rectangle, all we have to do is multiply the length times the width. For a square, the length and the width are the same size, aren't they? Well, the length times the width is the area, so we just have to multiply. We would write 3 times 3. 3 times 3 will give us the area of this square. What is 3 times 3? Do you know? Yeah, 3 times 3 is 9. The area of this square is 9 centimeters squared. That little 2 next to centimeters means squared. It tells us that the square has 9 square centimeters of space inside. That was so cool. What about this rectangle? What is the area of this rectangle? As you can see, it is 4 meters long and 2 meters wide. Remember, to find the area of a square or a rectangle, all we have to do is multiply the length times the width. The length times the width is the area. It's just simple multiplication. So we would write 4 times 2. 4 times 2 will give us the area of this rectangle. What is 4 times 2? Do you know? Yeah. 4 times 2 is 8. So the area of this rectangle is 8 meters squared. That little 2 next to meters means squared. It tells us that the rectangle has 8 square meters of space inside. As we are wrapping up, we want to share 2 quick tips about area. As you saw from our examples, when you find the area of a shape, the answer is always squared. If we discovered the area of a shape was measured in feet and the answer was 50, our answer could be written 50 square feet or 50 feet squared. The answer is always squared because area tells us how much space is inside a shape. The little 2 means squared. The second thing we want to mention is that you have to use a different multiplication equation to find the area of circles and triangles. In this video, we just learned the basics of area and how to find the area of rectangles and squares, but this is just the beginning and the start of an exciting math world. There is so much more about area to learn. Wow, okay. So we need to fit a lot of boxes in this warehouse, okay? But Bob isn't sure how much space is in here, okay? The warehouse is shaped like a rectangle, so I can just multiply the length times the width and figure out how many square feet are in this warehouse. Area is so cool. Wow, area is awesome. Oh, man. Math is so great. Oh, man. Wow. Hey, I wonder what Mr. Whiskers is doing right now.